You can see how crispy this poha chivda is. Hey guys, I'm Nisha Homi and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing a healthy poha chivda recipe. Poha chivda is a great healthy snack for kids and for adults. Homemade snacks are inexpensive and healthier than store-bought snacks. Store-bought snacks may contain added preservatives, additives, artificial flavors and colors. So try to avoid store-bought snacks and try to make snacks at home. Poha chivda is a very easy and healthy and inexpensive snack which can be easily made in just under 15 minutes. So let's get started with the recipe. Now this poha is made from Kerala's matta rice, also known as Kerala red rice. So the color of this poha is slightly reddish brown. And I buy this poha locally here in Kozhikode. Since I buy fresh poha from the local mill, the poha is very crisp, so you don't need to roast it before making the chivda. So if your poha is not fresh and is not as crisp as mine, then you will need to lightly roast the poha first and then make the chivda. Now instead of this variety of poha, you can use any locally sourced variety of poha. To make poha chivda, I have already chopped dried coconut into small pieces like this. So this is dried coconut, also known as copra in Malayalam. So I've just sliced a small piece lengthwise and then chopped it finely like this. Now I've measured 1/4 cup of cashew nuts and I'm just roughly chopping it. I'm using my deep dish cast iron pan. Now once the pan is heated, I'm adding in 4 tablespoons of wood pressed groundnut oil. Once the oil is heated, I'm adding in 1/2 cup of raw peanuts. Give this a mix and lightly roast the peanuts on medium to low flame. I used wood pressed groundnut oil in this recipe. However, you can use any unrefined or wood pressed oil from the place you live in, like mustard oil, coconut oil, til oil, or even desi ghee. I always prefer to use a cast iron pan, as a cast iron pan helps in better iron absorption. So if you have iron deficiency anemia, try to cook at least one of your meal in a cast iron pan. Poha chivda is a great evening snack for kids. You can make poha chivda easily at home and avoid packaged and store-bought poha chivda, which may contain added additives, preservatives or other artificial flavors. Now the best thing about cooking in a cast iron pan is that it retains more heat. So cooking is much more easier because of the high heat retention. As you can see, already the peanuts have started to roast well. I'm sprinkling in about 1/4 teaspoon of pink Himalayan salt so that the peanuts are nicely coated with the salt. And into this, I'm adding in the finely chopped coconut pieces. The coconut pieces should turn light golden brown. Since the coconut pieces are already dried, it will get browned very fast. So keep on stirring it. This poha chivda will keep good for about 1 to 2 weeks at room temperature. So you need to make sure that the moisture in the coconut pieces are absorbed. So that is the reason why you need to fry it until it is light golden brown. Okay, now the coconut pieces have started turning light golden brown. And at this moment, I'm adding in some pumpkin seeds. This will be around 1 tablespoon. Again, lightly fry this. Add in the chopped cashew nuts. Now instead of cashew nuts, you can also use almonds or any other nut of your choice. Now pumpkin seeds, I didn't buy it actually when I was making a sabji with kaddu. I just took out the seeds and washed and rinsed it and sun dried it. So whenever I make a sabji with kaddu, I always make sure that I remove the seeds and sun dry and keep it aside. Now give this all a mix. Add in 2 tablespoon raisins. Give it a stir. Move everything to one side. Into the oil, add in 1 teaspoon cumin seeds, also known as jeera. 1 teaspoon mustard seeds. half teaspoon red chili powder, 1 teaspoon turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon amchur powder, also known as dry mango powder, some fresh curry leaves, 3 to 4 whole red chilies. Just break them and add. Now give this all a stir. Quickly add in the poha. So I added 4 cups of poha. Now give this a mix. You need to mix this really well so that the spices and the masala are nicely coated in the poha. Since this poha is made from Kerala's red rice, also known as Kerala matta rice, the color of the poha chibida will be slightly brown. Sprinkle in half teaspoon pink Himalayan salt or as needed. Give this a mix. Now you need to mix this for about 2 to 3 minutes or until the poha is nice and crisp and all the masalas and spices are coated with the poha. And lastly, I am adding in 1 tablespoon of jaggery. Now this is not jaggery powder, I just crumbled the jaggery. I will leave the link to the organic jaggery I am using in the description box below. You can increase or decrease jaggery to suit your taste. The jaggery will melt with the heat and coat well into the poha. Now give this all a mix and let it roast for about 3 to 4 minutes. The organic jaggery I am using does not contain any mud or sand particles, so you can directly add the jaggery into it. So once the poha is roasted and is crisp, remove to a plate and allow it to cool down completely and then transfer it to an airtight glass container and it will stay good for up to a week or maybe even longer. So guys, do try this healthy poha chibida and let me know how it turned out. Don't forget to like, comment and share this video with family and friends. Thank you for watching and until next time, take care. Bye-bye.